The only thing that works is relentless practice. So that I'm just showcasing this relentless practice. Just did over 2 hours, and now, hey, it's still going. Totality cannot be objectified. Totality cannot be objectified. So when we try to get it, what we're trying to do is we're trying to get something from totality and objectify it. That's called getting it. So what we have to say is we can't get it. The ordeal of preparation for not getting it. That's a new title for the website. The ordeal of preparation for not getting it. Not getting it. I can't get it. Cannot get it. There's nothing to get. Now, in hunter-gatherer society, which we've been set up for a long time, the man's supposed to go out and get the food, bring it back. Well, the lady says, did you get it? I say, yes, this is what I got. She says, oh, you're great. You're wonderful. What a hero. My hero. You went and got it. But when it comes to totality, you can't get it. So this whole dichotomy of like the man's supposed to go get it and bring it back cannot. And we feel like, wow, there's something wrong with me, because the demand is still like, you know, as a man, you're supposed to get it. You're supposed to get something objective. You can eat, you can objectify. You got the house, you got the car, you know, supposed to get it. Cannot get it. So you're a failure in the eyes of this dichotomy. See, failure, you can't get it. Nothing to get. I say, well, what use are you then? What use are you? Useless. You're useless. Complete idiot. Useless idiot. Not even a useful idiot. A useless idiot. Can't get it. There's nothing to get. You cannot objectify totality. What I see is people waiting for someone to get it for them. I mean, is it whether it's females waiting for the male, or males waiting for someone to the male to get, or the female to get it, whatever. We're all waiting for someone to get it. I say, at least symbolize it. How can you symbolize totality? You cannot symbolize totality properly. It's meaningless. It's misleading. Oh, here's a beautiful song. This is a song, a song to totality. There's nothing to get. And what's happening in this world is, because you can't get it, materialism is so powerful now. And the voice of materialism is often driven by, marketers know this, corporations know this, but what is it? 80% of purchasing decisions are made by the women. And so they said, hey, you're the ones who need to say, this is what you got to get. And so we're saying, hey, man, you know, you get it. If there's something to get, you got to get it. And you say, look at the history. You didn't get it for us. You're a failure. All this stuff from the past is nonsense. Where's the product? Where's the product? Where's something that corporations can manufacture? This is the sort of the underlying agreement of the new world order is consumerism and corporations. And it's driven through the women of the world who do put most of the pressure, are really behind most of the purchasing decisions, and put the pressure on. Look, this is what you need to get. We need to get this. I like this. And so they're saying, hey, wait a minute. You're saying you can't get it? It's not something gettable? Well, then it's no help to corporations. It's no help to corporations. So there's this mutual sort of agreement between corporations and the feminine of this world. It is, we can make this wonderful new world order because we'll just keep everything in the realm of what we can get. None of this stupid speculation that men have been dreaming about. Totality, non-dual, absolute. There's nothing to get. What is that for? It's nothing. Come on, let's focus in on what we can get. And the women say, yeah, that, all right. That sounds good to me, because we, you know, the more we get, the better we feel. The better life is. This is the overall mindset of the world right now. It's this marriage between female consumeristic tendencies and corporations, which are also often run by men too. So, you see, it's an agreement between men and women here. Materialistic men, materialistic women. Both, okay? And this is the neat little prison they have for us. But more and more the corporations are being taken over by women. Most spokespersons are women now for corporations, actually. A lot of the marketing is done by women. A lot of the stuff is being done now because it seems like they know what they want. No more of this pie in the sky, I can't get it-ness. You know, let's stick to concrete stuff we can get. That's how we're going to be happy. That's how my children are going to be happy. I'm not going to waste their lives on focusing on the non-dual absolute abidance where there's nothing to get. That's ridiculous. How can they be happy? How can my grandchildren be happy? Come on. Let's focus in on better distribution, better production, better distribution, better marketing, more sensitive to our needs. What do we need as consumers? Let's become sensitive to the consumer. What does the consumer need? What does this consumer want to get? Let's be sensitive to that. This is what's happening in the world. This is what has been happening in the world for quite some time now. This is the great crystallization that is coming, that people call a new age, is sensitivity to the consumer, to the sensitive consumer. Being able to market, what are your needs really? And meeting our needs more specifically and precisely and technically, and just it's going to be custom designed, you know, needs. Sybaritic, hedonistic luxury, materialism, this car is just exactly what, everything's exactly what I need. I got this, I got it. So the whole picture of a society focused on that totality, which can never be objectified, there's no way to objectify it, that's all taboo. It's becoming a myth. It's being mythologized as non-existent. And the men are being blamed in the past. Are you men? You spent your time on these religious orders meditating and looking for the absolute, you know, and you neglected the needs of women. How awful. You could have been, you know, working in the coal mines, in the gold mines, digging out the gold and the diamonds and manufacturing stuff and setting up bigger factories, you know, more. You could have been focused on getting stuff. Beautiful, more beautiful clothing, more beautiful homes, more, you know, golden age. You should have been doing that all this time. You wasted our time. You wasted thousands of years of our time. How terrible. What a sin. What an awful sin. And so men have taken on this guilt. They've taken on this guilt. Very rarely will you see any man in this world who is not totally burdened with this guilt towards the female, saying, I wasted my time, I neglected her. I was not responsive enough to her needs, what she needed. She needed this, need this, 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 this. Oh, I just need the yard clean all the time. I need everything looking perfect all the time. I need everything perfect for my needs all the time. It has to be complete, you know, yeah, forever and forever and forever. So the guilt, the male guilt in this world is what's crippling the path. That's what's crippling, spiritually crippling everybody here. And so what I'm doing is I'm giving some air to everyone here. Say, hey, everybody, take some deep breaths. Say, this is not the way. This is not the way. This is absolute foolishness. Cannot objectify totality. And there's only totality. There's only totality. There's nothing else. As I pointed out in so many videos. This is the problem, though, and I'm just pumping some oxygen in so people can keep breathing. But the male guilt and the females stoking the fire of male guilt, thinking that they will turn their attention towards getting better invention, okay, invent stuff we want, better manufacturing, better design, more choices in design, better distribution, better service, constant new designs and new choices, you know, just fed our senses, fed our desires. And so we can go into the store shopping and it's just like, wow, it's like heaven. I just entered heaven. This is paradise. You go into stores now, and if you're materialist, it's like, I think this is almost paradise, because everything is different than it was last year completely, or 6 months ago. And it's all new designs, all new colors, all new fonts, new bells and whistles, and it's, you know, eco-friendly, and friendly to this, and friendly to that, and it's friendly, and I can bring this home, and it's going to make my life more friendly and more purposeful, and this is, you know, this is progress, where we're entering into nirvanic paradise, nirvanic materialistic paradise. This is exactly what's happening. I don't even go into stores anymore. I really don't. I used to all the time. I was monitoring the whole situation until I really got a sense of what's going on. But occasionally, rarely, I'll go into a store and I'll just say, wow, look how streamlined they got all this, you know, everything. It's just like making it seem like, you know, it. And of course, they say happy wife, happy life. So for the man, if he doesn't make the wife happy, his life's going to be hell. And the wife is saying, hey, all you got to do to make me happy is get everything I need, cater to my needs, my materialistic needs. And of course, the corporation is applauding. You know, the corporation is this audience in back. And every time the woman says, yeah, man, you got to get what I need, corporation applauds. Bravo, bravo, bravo. And the actress says, thank you, thank you. This is my best role. This is what's going on. And the man's like, wow, I can never do enough. I just got to make up for so much lost time. You know, I spent all my time reading spiritual books and thinking maybe I could escape this horrible prison, you know, and now I find out that was all wrong. You know, and I was neglecting, and now I can't, it's impossible to escape until the woman is happy. And then when she's happy, then, you know, then I'll be able to be happy. That's what the corporations, this whole thing, is this marriage made in hell between the corporation and the consumer feminine. Is this marriage made in hell, actually? And again, I said, I've talked to people who go around to thousands and thousands of home service stuff, service-oriented men. They say every single household they go into, without exception, the woman is calling the shots, period. Period. Man is just a dog to do what she wants to do, without exception. So the women are wearing the pants entirely, and they're the ones who are saying, this is what we want, this is what we want, this is what we want, this is how you can be happy, because you're not going to be happy until I'm happy. You see, that's the... So they say, I'm working for your happiness, you know, because you can't be happy until I'm happy. You have to learn how to objectify what I want. You know, I need to find what I want, objectify it. Now, of course, there's men and women realize there's a few here and there say, hey, this is bad news. This is a trick. This is a trick. We're being deceived big time. Absolutely deceived big time. Is the corporations knew how to exploit women. Okay, they knew how to exploit women. And the thing about women, they also know how to exploit corporations. See, and they say, why not, let's use both our talents here. You know, they see it's like a win-win situation. It's a win-win situation. They know how to put the fear of God into corporations, women do. Because the laws and everything, all they have to do is scream, discrimination, sexual harassment, and discrimination. And the corporations that fire everybody and say, okay, here you go, here, you become CEO, please. We're so scared. They're so scared. It's a symbiotic relationship, you know. Marriage made in hell. The serpent and Eve, actually. And so, you know, spiritual men and women, both, as they try to, you know, realize there's nothing to get, there's this enormous pressure on them to get something. And to bring it back and say, okay, here's an object. Here's something in the core. Corporations can probably reverse engineer this, and well, they can manufacture it, distribute it. Happy world, happy world, happy world. My God, you know, everything's great. And so there's so much pressure now. It's very difficult for anyone to accept there's nothing to get, and then to, you know, share this with the world. Nobody's interested. You may think men will be interested. No, they're not. because the women have trained them into thinking, you're not happy until I'm happy, period. Right? And they also say, and the corporations say to the women, you know, you're not happy until we're happy. And she says, well, yeah, and you're not happy until I'm happy. And so everything's locked up this way here. It's a prison. And everyone's made this agreement, like, this blackmail, you're not happy till I'm happy, but don't say anything about it. Let's all pretend it's not happening. Let's all pretend it's not happening. And maybe it will work. See, no, there's no chance of it working whatsoever. Complete waste of time. But everyone's so locked into this guilt. And the guilt is so extreme. You know, women can bring tremendous guilt on men, actually. Almost kill them with guilt. And they certainly try. And so what they're doing is just establishing this fact of guilt, that men are inherently guilty. And once men accept that, then they say, okay, but here's the good news. You can be absolved. As soon as I'm happy, you're absolved. Now go buy that stuff the corporations are marketing for you. I want that. You know, go out there and get the money. You know, come on, let's go. We want to be happy, don't we? You don't want that, carry that guilt forever, do you? Okay. Super nasty stuff, actually. Unbelievably nasty stuff. And we're all subject to it. All men are subject to this blackmail of guilt right now. Actually, the pressure from both all the women of the world and all the corporations of the world, the whole business, the whole economic structure, is aiming to put this guilt into men, that they're guilty. And then once that's there, you see, they think, oh, the whole machinery of the New World Order paradise utopia will ever go smoothly, and the men will be happy slaves. And they'll go out there and, you know, get the money, and get the money, and give it to the women. The women will go out there, shop. The corporations sell. Everybody's happy. And what? Non-dual, absolute, abidance. What? Ah. Gone with the wind. So, you know, I don't know if there's any man in the world who isn't riddled with this guilt, actually. It's still on me a little bit. I can feel the pressure is going to just, you know, you got to be forced into accepting guilt. And of course, Jesus tells us there's no such thing as guilt. No such thing as guilt. Everything, all that happens is our choice. Choice. I mean, people can choose to neglect their ordeal of preparation. That's their choice. And therefore, they're going to end up being completely, very foolish. That's their choice. Nobody forced them to be foolish. Can't force anyone to be foolish. Happiness doesn't come from consumerism. They believe that, that's their choice to believe it. See? So there's no guilt. There should be no guilt in anybody. I don't feel guilty towards anyone, really. And nobody should feel guilty. But the way the laws have been rigged in this planet now is they're designed to force the man into accepting guilt, actually. See, women don't feel guilt about anything, really. They just have regrets about wasting their time. You know, they have regrets about not taking a hard line on men earlier. Why didn't we do this long ago? God, we're stupid. Because they had tried that before, it didn't work. You see, and then this resurgence of truth came into the world, and men said, "Hey, wait a minute. This whole thing doesn't work." What you're doing, this guilt trip, doesn't work. So we're going to try and shed that, and this will be beneficial to all, because it doesn't work for anybody. Man, now back it comes again. You know, back comes the the materialistic, like the history repeating itself, as it were, of secular materialism and the technology and all this stuff. And saying, why are you wasting your time just sitting there in silence saying, there's nothing to get. What an idiot. You know, go out there and get me a new Tesla or something. And you want to be happy? Make me happy. And then you'll be happy. What's the big deal? How come you don't get it? That's easy to get. If I'm not happy, I'm going to make life hell for you. So you might as well give me the Tesla. And, you know, a new, you know, new purses and things to do. And make me happy. I'll be happy. You'll be happy. Everybody's happy. End of story. So there's this ungodly pressure upon everybody here to buy into this nonsense. Yeah, I think it's the worst it's ever been on this planet. That's what we're told, the end times. The pressure will be the worst it's ever been. There'll be nothing like it's ever seen in the world before, of how much pressure there is to accept guilt and to look at your efforts towards realizing there's nothing to get. Totality that can't be objectified. And accepting that. All I have to do is accept totality cannot be objectified, and that's it. Done. And we're not allowed to, as far as, you know, socially, we're not allowed to. Hey, reality, totality cannot be objectified at all. What we are, our identity cannot be objectified. Our identity cannot be objectified. And all this attempt to establish identity based on objectification is just a waste of time. Ultimately, we're actually formless. The pressure to disavow that, you know, is off the charts right now, off the charts. I don't know if anybody can withstand it. I don't know. And it's getting, you know, doubling every day, virtually, the pressure here in this world. That's how bad it is. It's a pyramid-like growth, you know, of the pressure. And that's what we're told in Scripture, saying the end times will be, the pressure will be just unbelievable. And even those that know that totality cannot be objectified will start acting as if it can and feel guilty over their beliefs. They feel something wrong about their recognition that the reality is wrong, is bad. It's not helping the lady, you know, it's not helping the lady out. Help the lady out. This is what we're all told, and yeah, that if you see, we're told that we'll get into heaven if we do good for others, especially what we're told. The whole New Age is based on this principle. A false principle of women have been neglected, they've been mistreated. This is the premise. You're not going to get into heaven at all. See, that's why you haven't got in yet. So you need to treat women like goddesses, whatever they want, you know, just cater to their needs, take care of them, help their health, take care of them in every way possible, do whatever they want, and that'll build up good karma for you, and then you'll get into heaven. Now, doesn't this sound like a nice scam to you? It is a scam. It is a scam, absolutely. Imagine if you could tell, you know, the women of the world, say, hey, women of the world, which this scam may have been used also, is that, hey, women of the world, you can't get into heaven. And the reason why you can't get into heaven is because you're not serving the men. Do whatever the men want. And if you do whatever the men want, that'll get you into heaven. So that scam has been used to some extent, although it may have been greatly exaggerated by the new scam that says, oh no, we've been so completely mistreated throughout history, the women, men, the reason why you're not happy is and can't get into the heavenly state of mind is because of your terrible karma, the way you treated women. So you have to then balance that karma out by spending the next couple thousand years as slaves to them, you see. The women say, hey, this is a pretty good deal. All of them, you know, what a great scam. What a great scam. It's all a scam. The whole thing is a scam, 100%. There's no such thing as getting into heaven. You're already there. You can't not be there. That's the whole thing. You can't not be there. You cannot not be there. Everyone is already there. There's no place else to be. There's no karma. You can't not be in heaven. Not going to be karma. How can it be somewhere else? The way you're someplace else other than in pure spaciousness? Where is that? There's no place. Everyone is already in heaven. There's no place else to be. You can't ever go out of heaven. You can't ever get away from it. You can't ever have bad karma. You can't even have good karma. You're always there. And wherever you are, you're always exactly where you've always been, which is in heaven, in the totality. There's only the totality. There's nothing else. So it's all this nonsense about karma and levels and layers and needing to get there, needing to atone for what you've done. And this is a total scam. This is a total scam of materialists. It's a materialistic scam to get you to keep working on objectifying appearances as if that's somehow going to, solve our underlying dread that reality isn't real and there is this pit that we're in, which there isn't. It just feeds delusion. The more you go with secular materialism, the more delusional you become, the more severe your continuity problem becomes. So it's a lose scenario in the world right now. You can't get it through guilt. And again, I said, men are like almost cannot function without this guilt. It's unbelievable. It's unbelievable. They think they need to be worshiping some goddess. That's the only way to get to heaven. Again, you can't not be in heaven. You can't not be in heaven. Nobody is not in heaven. You are right now. And there's nothing to get. There's nothing to get. But still, the guilt is working in everybody. And the continuity fear unacknowledged is working. And the man says, wow, I got this severe continuity fear. I'm afraid. And the woman says, don't worry. If you worship me, that will solve your continuity problem. And that's what's going on. Another scam. Oh my God, this is like, these scams have always been around and they're just all right now, sure. The woman's very shrewd, says, wow, the guy, he's afraid to wake up. Okay, I'll tell him, just worship me, turn me into a goddess, meet all my needs, and that will solve your continuity problem for you. And the guy says, oh, that's great. That's just what I needed. It won't solve your continuity problem at all. Just makes things worse, just more frightening, because you think that you need that goddess there as an intermediary. And so it's like you build up valuing and need, instead of evaporating all that. You should evaporate it. No body, no world, no problem. You see, you have to work the opposite of what the world is telling you to do, the opposite. But guilt, which comes from the continuity of your unacknowledged, makes fools of us all. And everybody thinks, hey, the situation's pretty good, because the women tell the men, don't worry, we're solving your problem for you, because you treat us the way we want to be treated, and we'll talk to God and say, God, they're okay now, you can let them in. There is no letting you in. You're already there. If you think you need somebody's approval to be where you already are, then that's insanity, that's delusion. You don't need anyone's approval. You can't get anyone's approval. There's no approval. God says, you know what? I'm going to approve that you're there. You've always been there. There's no such thing as approval. You don't need anyone's approval. There's no guilt. Everybody is there. How could there be guilt? Everything's perfect. Everything's always been perfect. How can there be guilt? How can there be karma? Can't. There cannot. That is a scam. And we see how it's working out now. This whole thing about guilt and karma. I need to atone. I need to treat people the way they want to be treated. Yeah, sure. Of course. Gee, my car is dirty. Could you go out and clean my car? You wouldn't mind, would you? And then the next time, and you know, the next time you see it's dirty, just go ahead and take care of it. Yeah, you don't need my approval to do it. Just you can take care of that. And, oh yeah, and then this, you can take care of that too, and you can take care of that too, and you can take care of that too. So when I go out, regal, you know, here comes regality. Without even asking. See, the slaves don't even need to ask. They know exactly, okay, wash the car, make the wheels nice and bright and shiny, vacuum the inside of the car, clean the window every day, make sure it's gassed up, make sure, you know, everything's perfect, and then on and on and on and on and on, like servants, 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 servants. That's exactly what's going on. It's exactly what's going on. And the women are frantically working to see how many servants they can get. That's the game. That's the new game, actually. That is the new game here in this world. How many male servants can the women get? And so there's a frantic status struggle going on right now among women, actually. Among women. Tremendous status struggle. That's where they're all in there, the yoga, you know, just, look at me, I deserve more servants than you do. You know, I'm so toned. I'm so, you know, I'm so balanced. I'm so cool. I'm so awesome. So much awesomeness. I deserve, you know, twice as many servants as you do. The issue right now in the world is only about that. How many servants do the women get? There's nothing else going on really between men and women. For the women, it's already set. The guilt is there. The atonement needs to be made. The karma needs to be burned off. Service to women has already been settled. It's just now, how many do we get? Divvying up. They're casting lots, you know. Casting lots. How much do we get? So out there running, you know. I'm an alpha dominant female. I deserve, you know, 10 times the servants you do. And men are just like sitting there just waiting and says, well, who am I going to serve? Who am I going to serve? How do I get rid of this terrible karma I have? This terrible guilt that I have? This terrible wrong? I've wronged women so badly, you know. I've been preventing them from getting into heaven, you know. Well, the thing is acceptance of the scam by either one gender means acceptance for the other, right? They want to keep it alive, keep this whole scam alive. Fear keeps it alive. And it may go ping pong back and forth between the two genders, you know, who enslaves who. Right now we're in a period totally of females enslaving men, totally. It's just omnipresent, you might say, in this world. As a man, you can't do anything actually right now unless the female overseer okays it. You can't do anything, basically. I'm doing these videos without real approval. On the sly, as it were, and tacit approval, but yeah, I'm fortunate, a little bit fortunate. At least my wife has common sense, you know, common sense. So she's not buying into the whole scam, really, not entirely, because I won't go along with it either. But what we're losing is common sense to at least have a balance. Common sense balances things enough so we don't plunge into the scam of enslavement. Plunge into this scam of enslavement. But we have plunged into it. We threw out common sense. Now see, common sense doesn't provide a utopia, a vision of utopia, does it? No, it doesn't. But what it says is, hey, at least we don't want to go into the hell, right? Let's stay in purgatory here and let's see if we can focus on what's going to work here. At least we got a chance. But common sense gives us a chance. And you can tell these days if there's a woman of common sense. You can tell. You can tell right away. As a man, you can tell how it's obvious. It comes through the attitude. It's not condemnatory. It's not trying to put guilt on you. It's saying, you know, they listen and they say, okay, man, maybe I don't agree with everything. And might not agree with everything I say, but common sense tells us we'll have disagreements, and we can't really work everything out. We can't have perfect relationships here in the world anyway, and let's not go overboard here with condemnation and guilt. That doesn't work. And so there's not this accusatory, you know, thing, domination thing. It's not there. You can tell, you can feel right away. You can really feel it. A lot of women you know, have been that way and want to remain that way, but the pressure's on incredibly severely. And at any moment, they could decide, you know what, I'd sure like to have a slave too. So you can't entirely trust a situation. You know, how much pressure can they take? Because they see all these other women like just being treated like goddesses. And here they are, you know, just like nothing. Just seems like, wow, they feel so lowly because the man is spending his time, you know, recognizing, accepting the absolute, and on the path to towards actual, you know, good advice and liberation from insanity, actually. But maybe materially, you know, it's very low, very low, very low. So it's very tough on the woman, because she judges herself according to the other women. It's like, well, look at them. They got all these maid servants. They get everything they want. They're raising up in the world, better houses, better cars, better clothes, better vacations, better everything. And it's brutal on them. You know, they think, wow, boy, I'd just sure like to have a few servants of my own, you know. So the situation cannot be trusted at all. Cannot be trusted at all. It's insanity. I mean, any woman with common sense will say, don't trust the situation, right? They say, you know, I might collapse too. The pressure might get to me too, for sure. Absolutely. Absolutely. So I do not put my faith in this world situation at all. At all. It is a slave-making monster at this, you know, at this point. That is all it is. You cannot push out in the world very effectively anymore unless you accept this basic premise that men are guilty. You have to. I see these teachers, and you can tell they've accepted this premise, and so they get interviewed by the women, you know, they get on, you know, media, social media, they get known because they've accepted the basic premise. Oh yeah, the divine feminine, yeah, that's absolutely, that needs to be in charge. Absolutely, absolutely it is, yes, yes. And now, yeah, I mean, and non-dual, blah, 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 blah. They basically have to kowtow to that. And if they don't, they're going to get in trouble at some point, for sure. Some woman will say, well, you know, touch me inappropriately or something. I thought, if they looked at me the wrong way, I feel uncomfortable, you know, something isn't quite right. And then the man asks, oh, mea culpa, you, the divine feminine is wonderful. That's the answer for sure. Good. Okay. It's wonderful. Welcome, 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 welcome. We're glad that you're with us. The insanity of it is complete here. It's absolute bonkers, this world. And you have to keep a sense of humor about it, or else you'll just be going to depression. Right? Going to depression. But see, and once men keep, enough men accept, as they have, this belief that they are inherently guilty, then even the women with common sense will look at the men and say, wow, they're all insisting that they're guilty. Because men are insisting that, you see? And then the women with common sense will say, wow, I do need to treat them. I do need to be the dominant one. I do need to, you know, I have to help them with their karma. Otherwise, they'll never get to heaven. They need to die for me, actually, or else they'll never get to heaven, you see? You know, go out there, slaves, and fight those battles and bring back the riches for me. Otherwise, that's how you burn your karma off. Again, there is no karma. There's never been karma. You've never left heaven. No one has left heaven. Nothing has ever happened to anyone. Nothing has happened to anyone. No one has any needs. No one's been alone, separated, neglected. Nothing has ever happened. Nothing can ever happen to the totality. Nothing can happen to the totality. And the totality is all there is. There isn't anything else. But of course, you see that, you don't have any guilt. And then the people of this world will say, you must be the worst, evil, terrible person. You know, you're damned, because how can you be saved? You got to burn your karma off. Otherwise, you can never be saved. That's the scheme. So they feel so sorry for you. I feel so terrible for you. I can't even hang around you, because it just drags me down thinking of just how you're going to be left behind. You know, how can the totality be left behind? What can leave the totality behind? Right? What leaves it behind? The totality. for sure. You won't hear anywhere else for sure. Because everybody else is too interested and say, whoa, I better play the spiritual politics of this situation. But it waters down the message, right? The subliminals of their messages are pushing guilt on you and atonement. Guilt and atonement. Guilt and atonement. There is no guilt. That is the atonement. Okay, there is no guilt. That is the atonement right there. Final judgment is there is no judgment. That's the final judgment right there. There's no good karma, there's no bad karma. There's only perfection, which is what the totality is. The totality is perfect. The totality is perfect. And there's nothing other than the totality. There's no one trying to get into the totality. How could there be anyone trying to get into the totality? You see, how could there be anyone getting into the totality? Someone knocking on the door. Hey, I've been left out of the totality. How do I get in? Well, you need to go worship a goddess for the next 10,000 years and sacrifice yourself over and over and over, and then you can get in. Oh, really? Thank you. Thank you for telling me how to get into the totality. There is who's outside of the totality? Nobody. Nothing. There is no outside of the totality. There's nobody trying to get into totality. Now, I know people say blah, 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 you know, and give the Don Dual talk, and that's great. You know, he can't be objectified. And I said, good, good, good. But let's talk about the pragmatic situation in the world, and people aren't getting it, really. They're not really getting it. I say, well, yeah, great, but how do I get rid of this guilt? So this needs to be talked about. Nobody's talking about it. Nobody's talking about it. It's taboo. It's completely taboo. Because they think that somehow if they don't do that, the women are going to be kept out of heaven. It's a nice scam to say, I'm being kept out of heaven because of you. You know, if you treat me right the way I want to be treated, then I can get in. Nobody's outside of heaven. Everybody's already in. Everybody's already in. Everybody already has everything. There's only the totality. So anybody who says that you know, you have guilt, you have to help them get, that's a scam. That is an absolute scam to serve their materialistic, hedonistic, some people say Satanistic, Luciferian agenda, right, of spiritual pride. Spiritual pride saying we're better than God. We don't need God. We don't need totality. We can be happy outside of totality. And we just enslave all these people and get them to just work for us as slaves. We'll be happy outside of totality. Well, it's a dream of outside of totality, but the dreamer and the dream is not outside of totality at all. Nobody is. So you don't have to do anything for anybody in terms of getting them into heaven at all, getting into the kingdom. Everybody's already there. Everyone's already there. There's nowhere else but there. There's only here. Everyone is already here. Everyone is already here. Everyone is already here. Okay, everyone is already here. Now, this, you know, during the last couple thousand years, what's been told is that the men told the women, hey, you can't get into heaven, you don't have a soul, or something like that, you know, and oppressed them and stuff like that. Well, keep in mind that to be oppressed in such a way is to accept, yeah, I can't get into heaven, which is to what? Is to assert there's someplace other than heaven, which is really a hedonistic, Satanistic assertion, isn't it? So to even accept that, you see, accept it. See, no, it's forced on us. No, you can't force this issue on anyone. To accept it and to be oppressed, it's to assert that getting into heaven is something that has to be earned. And then you can flip the tables later on and say, hey, guess what, guides? The reason why you're not getting into heaven is because you didn't let me get into heaven. So now you got to boost me up into heaven, and then I'll pull you up too. And then you can enslave everybody. You see how the duality just keeps going and going and going? When you choose to be enslaved, you are asserting that it is possible to keep someone out of heaven, or there's some place other than you have to get into it. And you have to earn your way. Earn your way. How can you earn your way to be where you already are? What do you need to earn? There's a salvation by grace. Well, grace is just the self-evident fact that you already, there's no place other to be except the totality. The totality is heaven. The kingdom of heaven is the totality. And there's only the totality. There's nothing else. There's nothing else. Nothing is really objectified at all. There is no objectification actually at all. Everything is the totality. We are it. We are it. We've always been it. So there's a stupid Luciferian game, you know, that has been going on and on and on, and now it's the momentum is the guilt was set up last couple thousand years, using the guilt of that to flip the tables and now project the guilt on men, just keeping alive the same old false premise that we need to get into heaven. Get happiness, in other words, you know. That we need to get something. We need to get somewhere. Or somebody does, right? The guilty ones. The guilty ones need to, they're not yet worthy, right? Worthiness, right? They're not worthy. They're guilty. They're not worthy. They need to work off their guilt. And then someone will say, okay, you've worked off your guilt now. But keep in mind that you're still very prone to it, you know, and you can lose your position if you ever backslide, you know, backsliding. How can you backslide out of totality? How can anyone backslide out of totality? Oh, I'm falling, I'm sliding. Oh, I just left totality. I fell and now I'm misaligned with pure spaciousness. I'm misaligned with it. I'm out of alignment with pure spaciousness. These are all fantasies. These are vain hopes for oblivion, actually, which we think will set us on the throne and greater than God, oblivion. But keep the rant going. Keep the rant going if you can. You know, if you're on a rant, keep it going. It's good because what the world needs are rants, actually. Rants are meaning stream of consciousness, compassion in a stream of consciousness way of saying, hey, everything actually is perfectly okay. There's no such thing as worthiness or unworthiness. That's nonsense. There's no way you can be unworthy. And if there's no way you can be unworthy, how can you have a category of worthiness? If everyone's worthy, why do we need a category? Why do we need a term? Why do we need a definition? We don't. If everything is perfect, if everyone's worthy, why do we need a definition worthy? We don't. We don't need definitions at all. Reality doesn't need definitions. Totality doesn't need definitions. There's no way that it can ever be anything other than what it is. So what does it need definitions for? Definitions are contrary to distinguish one something from another. If there's everything's the same, what definitions do we need? We don't need to define we're worthy. So, what good is a rant? What good is a rant? I don't know. It pumps some oxygen into everybody that listens. And of course, the idea that women can't get into heaven is ridiculous. There's nowhere else to be. So for women to accept that is ridiculous. That's just to assert guilt. And then flip the tables later and use the guilt. You know, it just seems like this might be very useful at some point. This idea of not being, of worthiness and getting into heaven. Same thing for the men now, but they're so ridden with guilt, actually. And it's not so, it's fundamentally guilt, you know, that's driving the whole situation right now in the world. It really is. Guilt is rules right now in the world. Guilt rules is what rules right now. The rules of guilt is the fundamental governing principle of this planet right now is guilt. If you say there is no guilt, they say, you're going to tear down the whole structure of the planet. What do you mean the whole thing runs on guilt? The whole thing runs on guilt. Well, there's no reason why it can't keep running without guilt, actually. Or even way better, but I don't know exactly, you know, how it can play out. It's just that we do need to keep oxygenating our spirit, right? So to speak, metaphorically speaking, oxygenating our spirit with truth. So we don't succumb yet, but we may succumb in the future if we don't get some sort of additional clarity about, wow, because, yeah, the world does run on guilt. And if we were to take guilt out of the world, how would we run it? You know, that is a pragmatic point, actually. It is a pragmatic issue, really. So, I say maybe just those who realize that this is nonsense, maybe they go somewhere else. Or maybe those who want this guilt, maybe they divide off or somewhere. I don't know, separate off or something. I don't know. That has not yet clarified. But certainly, it seems as though the non-dual teachers, they're not getting anywhere right now. In fact, I've noticed over the years, I've been following a lot of them in various ways, seeing what's happening, and it's just like their mission just seems to be just falling, grind to a halt, and disappearing. You know, no more meetings, no more videos, because of this guilt factor. People now are obsessed with this dynamic of like, well, yeah, this is non-dual stuff. I got this severe guilt. I mean, I need to get something. I need to do what the lady tells me to do. She says, don't go to that teacher. That's a waste of time. You're not making me happy. How can your guilt be dissipated if you don't make me happy? So come on, be reasonable. They say, be reasonable. Well, is guilt reasonable? No, it's not. People are so used to using manipulating through guilt, they'll insist that they be victimized so that then they can use the guilt on others. They say, okay, now great. Now I got the leverage of guilt. Now I know how to live. Most people here don't know how to live without guilt. Those who are used to accepting guilt don't know how to live without it. And those who are used to imposing guilt on others don't know how to function without it. And so they will insist upon being victimized, often at a young age. And then later on they'll say, I've lived with this terrible secret for so long, and you guys have accrued so much guilt for what you've done to me, and so now I'm going to tell you how you can expiate your terrible sins. You see, it's almost like if you weren't abused as a child or something, you can't possibly get to a high position as a woman these days. You know, you have to have some terrible traumatic story, how terribly you were abused and everything, and then say, so I know exactly what everybody needs to do to atone for their sins, you know. And everyone goes, oh, great, and Goddess is here. She'll tell us how to atone for our sins, how to get into heaven, how can I work off this guilt. And this is the scam. It's a scam. It is an absolute Luciferian scam. Again, there's no place other than heaven. We're all in it right now. We've always been in it. No one's ever left. No one can ever leave. The idea of Lucifer saying he's leaving heaven is a joke. It's a joke. No one's ever left heaven. It's impossible. It's just a whim, like a foolish, whimsical, silly, prankish type of notion, you know, mischievous. Hey, I think I know a way to leave heaven. Oh, I left heaven, you know. Oh, I'm so guilty, I can't get back in, you know. This is all a mischievous prank. But it's just like so dispiriting the way the world is now, because people are really focused on how to atone for their guilt instead of realization. They're not really focused on realization. That's what I've seen. And it's like the leadership of women is like you have to be on a leash, or else don't have a voice at all. Nobody's going to listen to you. Is de facto, you know, as women have the voice, they're the ones that say, okay, guys, we know your guilt, how guilty you were, and we know how you can burn off this guilt. We'll let you know. It's open checkbook. Well, not that specific, but we'll just let you know, and we'll know when it's, you know, you burn off your guilt. You know, we'll let you know. So, what do I need to do? What do I need to do? What do I need to do? But keep it very vague, right? Because if you give someone, a man, a specific task, you need to do this, they have to do it. Boom, 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 boom. Done. They'll do it. Say, okay, I did it. So they say, well, you know, don't. Our intuition will tell us when you've burned off the guilt, and we'll let you know. Guy says, well, geez, I gotta do everything. Well, yeah, well, just, you just gotta, when we start feeling a little uncomfortable, you gotta know that that means that you're just not getting it very, you're not doing what you need to do. Oh, okay. So the men become complete psychic, emotional, spiritual slaves to the women this way. Slaves. Oh, you're uncomfortable. Oh my God. You know, what do I need to do? Everything. Okay, everything's wrong. I'm not working 24/7. That's what's wrong. Oh, spending 2 minutes of meditation. Oh, no, God, that maybe that's what's wrong. Maybe that's what's wrong. Okay, hey, I need some, like, instant enlightenment. Yeah, I still have enlightenment, but instant, you know, 5 minute enlightenment, boom. Can you, you know, so there's all these salesmen now saying, you know what, we got 5 minute enlightenment here, no problem. I say, great, that's about all I got. All the time I got. And so that's what's happening. Oh yeah. Okay, got it. Thank you. Back to work now. Back to work. Got so much guilt to atone for. Oh, I was an idiot, and I said, I saw all this guilt of the guys, and I said, wow, listen, guys, I'll take care of the goddess and do everything she wants for you so you don't have to. So you can spend your time meditating. You know, I said, I'll do that for you. You know, so I put all this burden on myself, trying to figure out a way. How can I make the world perfect for the goddess so the men can now go back to, you know, contemplation, the ordeal preparation. Not only men, but women too. I wanted to please the goddess so she's happy. So, okay, no more guilt. But then you just like to completely wipe myself out trying to do this. And there's no end to the demands, no end to the demands. Gee, you know, I want to see everything in this world absolutely perfect. Every moment. I don't want to see any dust on anything in the entire planet, ever. So go dust everything. I want to see every road absolutely smooth, always. I don't want to see even a crack in the road. I want, when I drive my chariot, I want the road. I don't want to feel the slightest bump. If I feel the slightest bump, you haven't been paying attention to my needs. Oh, okay. I want everything to be absolutely perfect. If it isn't, you haven't been paying attention to my needs. You're guilty. Well, this is the guys I've been, you know, dealing with my whole life, out of sympathy for everybody here, because the guilt trip they're on is just so extreme, just binding them. All these groups, women's groups, okay, say, okay, what do we want? This is what we want. Okay, let's decide, what do we want? How do we want the future to be? Okay, they're designing, this is what they want. And it's a given that the men then have to get, like that. They're not saying, hey, guys, what kind of future do you want? I mean, you want it to be materialistic, spiritual? I mean, what do you think's the best use of time? No, none of that. No input, no question, you know. It's a given, the next cycle, men are slaves. Slave mentality is everywhere for men. They cannot, you can just tell them instantly, slave mentality. I still have it myself in some ways, you know. It's hard to shake it here in this world. You gotta pretend you're not a woman, immediately snap into slave mentality immediately. Automatic, right? I'm guilty. I'm a slave. What do you want? Whatever you want. Like that. Because if you don't, they'll say, hey, you know, you must be out to, you know, abuse my self-esteem. You know, you're gonna be terrible. You're gonna be bad. You're gonna, you know, keep me from being happy. How is that possible? How can anyone keep anyone from being in heaven, from being in the totality? How can anyone keep anyone? How can anyone kick someone else out of totality? Desiree, how can totality kick itself out of totality? That's ridiculous. No one can kick anyone else out of totality. There's nowhere to go. And of course, the men will say, "Oh, you got to help us here, work off our guilt. If you want to help us, you've got to work off our guilt." You know, and I say, it's so difficult to say no to that. It's so difficult. Because they'll say, "We'll never get it." You know, the women just put this endless demands on us. Just, can you help us figure out a way to, you know, have more energy so we can do more things, you know, and get more done? Jeez, you know. Maybe you can do some of the stuff for us and help us out, you know. It's like that. There's no understanding in this world, really, about, you know, reality. Everybody says, look, the guilt's too extreme. I can't do it. I can't focus on it. You just got to take the pressure off me. So it's a bad situation. Very bad situation. You know, anybody who talks about freedom to the slaves, in a slave state, is an enemy. Like, you know, if you go to, gone in the past, you go to a place where there's all these slaves, and you go, "Hey, abolition, I'm an abolitionist, you know, let the slaves free, oh man, you know, you're tarred and feathered, run out of town. Don't be talking sedition, don't be talking freedom to the slaves, boy. Yeah, that's not acceptable. At least the abolitionists had some place to flee to, you know. In this world, do we have anywhere to flee to? No, not really. Not really. So where do you flee to? You flee to some other planet, some other place, actually. Yeah, you flee to someplace else. The abolitionists may need to flee, actually. Flee to Venus, planet very nearby, fourth dimensional society there. Maybe even a fifth dimensional, go to a fifth dimensional abode or something, but you may have to flee off this planet if you're an abolitionist, spiritual abolitionist. You may have to flee. Quite possible, actually. Quite possible. You know, it's always nice to have someplace where you can be safe, so to speak. Now, technically, I suppose you can, if you're perfectly enlightened, if you're, you know, you're no continuity fear at all, you could function here some way. Yeah. That's a big if. And Jesus always says, yeah, if you have perfect faith, everything will work great for you. You know, yeah. If. Who has perfect faith? Who has no continuity fear? Very few. Very few. So, pragmatically speaking, it may be necessary to flee this planet, I'm telling you. This is not a joke. If you're a spiritual abolitionist, a guilt abolitionist, saying, hey, there's no guilt. The planet will say, hey, you're calling upon for the collapse of civilization. And it's in the ruination of the planet. Because everything runs on guilt here. Which is why often spiritual groups would go off in the desert and disappear from society. Because society said, hey, you can't teach that here. Everything will collapse. And they do have somewhat of a point. Isn't technically it wouldn't collapse, but you can understand their fear is understandable. It is understandable. I'm not trying to say that it's ridiculous. It's not. It's a continuity issue, for sure. For sure. You know, how do you restructure? But the fact is we flip-flop the good lawyer, bad lawyer, the guilt from the female to the male. I mean, we flip-flopped everything in a matter of 50 years here of intense effort. Now the men are the slaves. You see, we've managed to flip-flop everything. So if we can do that and society didn't collapse, we certainly then can get rid of guilt, realize that there's no basis for guilt whatsoever, and society doesn't need to collapse either. If we really wanted to do it, we could do it for sure. For sure. There's a gradualism, just like this whole guilt trip has been gradualism. Intense gradualism. Everything geared towards that, actually. Drop by drop by drop, like rain. We look at the flooded river and we say, how's that possible? How'd that happen? Drop by drop by drop. Drop by drop by drop. billions and billions and billions and billions of drops. Well, we have the media now. We can put out billions of bits of information constantly, actually, in the world. So if we started gearing towards, you know, realizing there is no guilt, no basis for guilt whatsoever, nobody could ever be kicked out of heaven. Any way, possibility, totality. There's only the totality. There's nowhere else. We could gradually, you know, get rid of this horrible trap that we're all in, actually. We're all in it. Or, actually, we're not in it at all. But that scares us even more. So I'm looking back on my life here. And what I did was I said to the guy, hey, I said, I thought I saw a way to help. I said, hey, I'll take the guilt. Hey, ladies, I'm the bad guy, you know. The guilt's all on me. Forget about the other guys. They're not as bad as I am. I'm the worst, okay? You just put all your guilt on me. And then thinking that they'll forget about all the rest of the guys and say, okay, you're not so bad. You're not so bad. He's the one bad. And then I'll say, all the guilt's on me. And I say, guess what? There is no guilt, you know? And let me explain to you that there is no guilt. At least get their attention like that. Didn't work. Didn't work. Didn't work. It doesn't work. I don't know what works, actually, in terms of large-scale help here on the planet. I don't know what works in terms of short-term actually helping out. That's a big question. At least I know, you know, the question as far as, yeah, this didn't work. I think, you know, it's just like Jesus taking all the sins. Oh, you're the bad one. Everybody thinks, you're the bad one. Okay. And then he says, guess what? I'm not bad. Oh, really? How's that working? You know, and buy some oxygen for everybody else, sort of thing. The scapegoat. It's like a scapegoat. I tried to make myself a scapegoat, really. And backfired on me. Hasn't worked. So what works? What works? What works? What works is the question. What actually works? Don't know. That's the first step. I don't know. Don't know what works. Whatever I've done hasn't worked to really, you know, benefit the world. It's not working. And certainly, you know, trying to appease all the guilt doesn't work. That doesn't work. I've tried that too. I've tried everything here. Maybe going to Venus will work, actually. If people realize there's a way to escape, you know, there's somewhere to go. Maybe that'll change things. Like abolition, spiritual abolition, to say, hey, there's a place to go where you don't have all this guilt pressure so severely. How about that? And I said, wow, wait a minute, you know, how do I go there? Well, you got to drop this guilt thing. And, well, maybe I should. And it's possible. I don't. Something has to happen because the world is absolutely locked in this prison right now. Terrible prison. They don't even know it's prison. They think they're working for their happiness and their salvation. They're not. They're doubling down on madness, unfortunately. On pride. Doubling down on pride doesn't work. Doubling down on pride does not work at all. Makes it only worse. The continuity problem only worse. Worse, worse, worse. Man. So. This guy, this baseball player, used this term, man. There's a lady interviewing him after the game. And he said, he asked him a question. Of course, it's always a lady interviewing the hero and controlling the interview. He says, well, you're starting to hit now. You're starting to play good. And he goes, whew, man, yeah. It's just like, wow, this is great. I'm really getting into it. You know, he just used an expression like, wow. You know, just like, oh, man. That's just an expression like, oh, wow. And then afterwards he says, oh, I even got a man from him in this interview. Oh, you're like, oh my God, you know, it's like, she's so, you know, like really upset or something. You know, talk about controlling somebody, you know. It's just an expression of like, oh, holy cow, oh man. It's just an expression of, wow, yeah, this is great, wow. But you had to put this dig in, you know, to it. But I must say, the men announcers later in the booth said, we love you, man, to her. Yeah, we love you, man. See, they're not entirely cowed. They're older guys are not entirely cowed. Very interesting. It's not that, but you could feel the spiritual guilt dynamics at play right there. Say, hey, how dare you use that expression, man, to me? How dare you do that? Don't ever do it again. That was the implication. Don't you ever do that again. You're going to pay. You know, no slave speaks to their master like that. Get it? You understand, in a slave state, There are very strict rules about slaves addressing the masters. The eyes have to be downcast. You pass them by, you can't look at them. If you happen to see them, eyes straight ahead. You have no right to look at them. Don't you dare look at the lord and lady of the state, the plantation. The way you address them, yes, and you know, and it's all the subservience, this whole subservience thing and everything like that. That's what the way the whole situation is being structured now. Don't you dare address your the slave master that way. You're just a slave. You know, you have to show utmost deference that you understand that I'm doing you a big favor by enslaving you and enabling you to work off your karma. I'm actually doing you a huge favor out of the goodness of my heart. I'm not doing it for me, of course not. No, if I'm getting all these benefits from it, the goddess, it's not for me, it's for you. You burn off your karma, your terrible guilt you need to burn off. I'm just helping you do that. Really? Really? Gee, thank you so much. I think I'll go somewhere else. Thank you very much. And when the slaves figure out that they're somewhere to go, they can be free. Say, hey, I think we'll do that. I think we'll do that instead. Change things up a little bit. Absolutely. Okay, I hope you enjoyed the rant. You're probably not hearing many rants like this ever again anywhere. So I hope you understand that that is a blessing, right? It is a blessing to just realize, hey, you know what? Not everybody's crazy. Not everybody's fallen down in this trap. Not everybody's completely incapable of at least recognizing what's going on and saying, hey, you know what? We need to find a better answer than what's taking place here. We need somehow. There has to be an intervention here, actually. There has to be an intervention. And we talk about intervention in alcoholics' life, a dread acts life. We need a planetary intervention. This planet needs an intervention. It's so messed up right now. It is so messed up. It is so hung up on guilt. It's so hung up on slavery. It is so hung up on servitude, on surrendering your spiritual will. It's so hung up on that. Unbelievably hung up on it. Need a planetary intervention, actually. So maybe, not maybe, let's see, let's just keep an open mind. Okay, what's going to happen? What's truly going to happen? How can we be helped? Keep in mind, huge civilization on Venus, fourth dimension. Maybe other dimensions too. All the planets here have got higher dimensional civilizations. Basically, the whole solar system, the whole galaxy is full of situations. We are not some place where, we're not some plantation where they say, hey, but you know, ain't no place else you can go, man. You know, this is it. You keep the slaves so locked into thinking that their little plantation is the only place there is in the whole universe. So that, how can you go anywhere else? This is the mentality of this planet too, isn't it? Nowhere else to go. Venus, get there in a day. Get there in one day, easily. You don't think this Venus has transport ability? Interplanetary transport ability is an absolute piece of cake. They're so far advanced no sweat. One day you can be in Venus from here, from planet Earth. One day or less, easy. And actually, once you recognize it, you can be anywhere instantly, actually. But that's a higher, you know, it's a higher, we have to drop a lot of continuity for it to get there. But we're not trapped here on planet Earth. We can be in Venus in one day. Maybe the Venetians will say, hey, you know, welcome, we understand this is a bad situation, you got going, this guilt, the trip is not right. So, hey, sure, come here and get out of that atmosphere, you know, breathe some air, a little better air here. I'm not saying Venus is perfect. I'm not saying the culture on Venus is perfect, but it might be a breath of fresh air. It might be a breath of fresh air. That is quite possible. So start thinking outside the box here. Start thinking outside the plantation, the guilt plantation. And of course, the masters don't like to see the slaves leaving, do they? That they get really pissed then, right? They get really mad. Who's going to pick our cotton? You know, who's going to keep us in finery? Who's going to give us our profits if we don't have the slaves here, you see? We're not going to do it ourselves. Oh my God, we're going to fall down into poverty. This is horrible. Got to keep the slaves here. So this is the horrible situation here in this world of spiritual guilt. And I think a lot of people did the best they could to raise awareness, but if I don't see, much success happening, my God, there's someone makes a video a year ago and then there's no contact anymore. Someone is very enlightened, actually. On and on and on and on and on. It's just like collapsing. Okay, so maybe time for an intervention. Maybe time for a freedom, freedom railway, freedom road, so to speak. Maybe a time for an exodus from this planet. Maybe time for those to say, you know what, guilt isn't where it's at. Guilt doesn't work. We gotta find a better way. There is a better way. Ordeal of preparation. I've been showing you a better way. Absolutely. You cannot objectify totality. Accepting this, there's nothing to get. This is a burn. It just like, wow. How can I please, those who tell me I have to get something to please them? I don't need to. They never left either. This is just a guilt trip they're running on me to try to be greater than God. I don't need to serve that guilt trip of being greater than God. I don't need to go along with that. I can show them the way to get free of it. You have to have a positive cycle going like that. Okay. So, what an interesting rant this has been. Now I need to bring this to a close, and who knows what'll come out of my mouth next. I have no idea, and that's part of the fun of it. Okay, that's it.